I have a very distinct memory of TV telling me every hour the sun beams enough solar energy to power our planet for a year. Solar power, however, has yet to deliver on this promise from my children's television days. Why is it so hard? Hey there, sunshine. I'm Trace. Thanks for watching DNews. The sun shines on us every day. It comes down here, we gather it up, and we use it for energy. Boom, 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 done. But it's slightly more complicated than that, as you probably know. In 1873, electrical engineer Willoughby Smith discovered the element selenium was photoconductive. When exposed to sunlight, the metallic form of selenium becomes a semiconductor. 3 years later, other scientists discovered selenium could be used to create electricity from that sunlight. They dubbed that the photoelectric effect. When sunlight hits a metal like selenium, the electromagnetic radiation is absorbed into it. This fueled a whole host of physics nerds who are still arguing to this day whether light is a particle or a wave. It was such a big deal, the 1921 Nobel Prize in Physics was awarded to Albert Einstein, maybe you heard of him, for explaining the photoelectric effect and for his contributions to theoretical physics or whatever. Eventually, scientists discovered that light energy causes the freeing of electrons, which, if captured, could be used to generate electricity. This photoelectric effect has since been cultivated and researched and cultivated again, and the discovery that many different elements display a photoelectric effect opened it up for use in a number of inventions. Photosensitive cells are used in televisions, industrial processes, telecommunications, fiber optics, copy machines, spectroscopy, telescopes, and to sense pollution or emphasize other lights, like in night vision or infrared cameras. Plus, of course, solar panels via a photovoltaic cell. Photovoltaics were invented in the 1950s and were popularized by the space program as a way to power satellites. In the 1970s, pushes were made to modernize photovoltaics for use in commercial and residential power, but consumers mainly used them for calculators and watches and radios and little things like that. Like a battery, a photovoltaic cell has a positive and a negative to guide the electrons through the system. Each cell uses a pair of silicon wafers, one doped with phosphorus, negative, and one with boron, positive. From 1995 to 2010, solar energy use grew 20% a year, and now new inventions are making it even more affordable. Firstly, in 2009, China created way more solar panels than the market needed, and the price collapsed. And secondly, state and federal governments in the United States, Germany, the United Kingdom, and Japan are all giving subsidies to cultivate better renewable energy systems. This means more supply and demand for solar technology. And as money flows through renewables, they get better. Recently, the University of Queen Mary in London revealed that they can turn shrimp shells into cheap solar panels. The shells of crustaceans contain chitin and chitosan, which can be extracted into CQD, or carbon quantum dots. CQD solar cells aren't new, but usually use expensive ruthenium for this photoelectric properties. Instead, the researchers found this biomass product of shrimp industry can be used to extract CQDs and create fully renewable, cheap solar cells, which is pretty awesome. Fortunately, solar cells aren't the only place finding greener solutions for energy use. Toyota is too. The new Toyota Mirai is looking to the future with sustainability in mind, fueled by hydrogen and leaving zero emissions behind. Every year, renewable energy is getting better, but it's not yet as efficient as we'd hoped. For more on the efficiency of the most common types of energy production, check out my video about that here. These new panels convert 46% of their sunlight energy into electricity. Typical rooftop panels, for example, hover around 15% at best. What do you think is the most promising type of energy? Solar? Wind? Nuclear? Plain old coal, oil, and gas? Why? Tell me your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't subscribed yet, go up there and subscribe. We need you here. Thanks for watching DNews. Have a good one.